People could possibly live in the oceans as well, where temperatures are also not as extreme, and potential food sources like fish and aquatic plants are readily available.
Oh! And water world!
Hello, my condemned victims! Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new. So last time, things didn't work out as well as I had planned. And I think I know why. I just haven't been bold enough lately. There was a time I was throwing a meteor on Earth, or freezing the whole planet, you know? Sure, killing all insects is interesting, maybe even somewhat effective, but it's too subtle. My old plans had more drama. They looked cooler. So today, I'm back to the old end. The one who wanted to kill humans, but not just in any way. The one who wanted his plan to be the finest, the greatest, most excellent, perfect, outstanding!
Searching synonyms of best.
Oh my god, SC! Read the room! Anyway, today I'm making Earth stop spinning. I can't even announce stuff in a cool way anymore.
The Earth stops spinning. Setting parameters. Earth currently spins around its own axis once every day. At the equator, the speed of this rotation is 1,070 kilometers per hour.
Yeah, that's a lot of kilometers. Okay, that's real fast. Yeah, so pretty damn fast.
The equilibrium between the centrifugal force of the rotation and the gravitational force defines the Earth's ellipsoidal shape and sea level height, as well as much of its appearance.
Okay, and this centrifugal force thing is no joke. Not only is the equatorial radius of Earth 22 kilometers bigger than the polar radius, this force also makes the oceans bulge at the equator. The sea levels are actually 8 kilometers higher there than at the poles. Kind of like this.
In this simulation, the Earth stops spinning around its own axis. The revolution around the Sun, however, remains unaffected. If the Earth suddenly stopped rotating, many destructive consequences would immediately ensue. Because of the speed of the Earth's rotation, if the planet was to stop spinning, inertia would cause everything on and surrounding Earth to continue moving in the same direction and speed until something stopped it. This results in colossal tsunamis and total collapse of buildings. People at the equator, for example, would be thrown at a speed of 1,070 kilometers per hour. All land masses would be scoured clean of anything not attached to bedrock. This means rocks, topsoil, trees, animals, and so on would be swept away into the atmosphere.
Fun fact though, since on the poles the Earth doesn't really spin, Santa would be totally fine. Wow. Santa's a dick. But anyways, this looks pretty cool. And destructive. And we all know...
I do like destructive.
I mean, it would maybe even kill most humans.
Probably.
But it is way too quick. Wrecking humans is not something to speed through. This is something I want to savor. Taking more time can make things even better. So I
will take my time.
If the Earth would gradually stop spinning over the course of a few years, however, the planet would become a completely different place than what we know. Without the additional force of rotation, the Earth's appearance would be solely determined by the gravitational force. Whereas oceans and atmosphere adjust quickly to the new equilibrium, in a matter of days or months, the crustal topography would take millions of years, as it is extremely sluggish. The Earth would slowly get back to its round shape, now that the centrifugal force is no longer at play. Faster than that, however, would be the oceans, which would quickly migrate to the poles, forming two polar oceans without connection. The new North Ocean would cover whole countries like Canada and most of Russia. In the south, sea levels would not be as high, and the ocean would get to where nowadays is Canberra in Australia. In the center, a new ring continent would arise, and what used to be oceanic floor becomes dry land. One could walk around the whole world over this new continuous strip of land. The regions that today are continents would turn into high mountains, considering the new sea level. Across the equator, these mountains would get a high incidence of sun, making them particularly arid.
This is going to be the coolest thing ever! I need to immortalize this moment! Oh, where? Shit! Where the fuck is my kid? Yeah.
The lack of rotation would also result in 6-month-long days and nights, which would have great impact on the temperature at the Earth's surface. On the dark side, temperatures could go as low as minus 75 degrees Celsius, while the sunny side could have temperatures up to plus 75 degrees Celsius. The new configuration of oceans and sunlight would also influence winds, which would flow fast and continuously from the cold side to the warm side.
Yes! 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 Yes, I made it! Woo! Woo! Oh, man. Just imagine. It's a sure thing. So many cities will be completely destroyed by the change in oceans. The cold side is too cold, the warm side is too hot, and with climate being so extreme and different from what it is now, you can't grow food. Literally, the only good things about this scenario are A, fish can still survive in the cold waters of the polar oceans, and B, the world would be like a George Miller fever dream. But humans? Humans are done.
Error, you are once again wrong.
Wow, that hurt.
Error, there would still be habitable areas for humans.
And simulating things on her own again. Maybe I should be worried. Maybe SC got herself a virus.
On a non-spinning Earth, life would still be possible in certain pockets of coastal land between the light and the dark side. These areas, hereafter referred to as twilight zones, would still have average temperatures that allow for humans to survive. Their geographical location in the four intersections between light and dark sides means they have moderate incidence of UV light. That, combined with their closeness to the polar oceans, makes the climate tolerable.
Wait. Is this actually Mad Max?
However, the twilight zones would be in constant motion, meaning humans would have to continuously move around 80 kilometers a day in order to follow the habitable areas. Life would be technically possible, but much different from what we currently know.
And Snowpiercer?
People could possibly live in the oceans as well, where temperatures are also not as extreme, and potential food sources like fish and aquatic plants are readily available.
And water world!
Hey guys, so you may be asking yourselves, why do I look so happy? Honestly, I didn't expect to feel this way either. Ending humanity is definitely something I want badly. But you have to admit that producing the love child of three amazing post-apocalyptic movies is pretty damn cool as well. Maybe I should start simulating scenarios like this more often.
That doesn't mean I got there for me.
What the f- Anyways, of course I was joking. I just think it's important to celebrate small victories. My plan today may not have killed humanity, but it got my creative juices flowing. Next time, I'm definitely gonna make it. You know, I'm nothing if not an optimist. So don't forget to leave a like on this video and subscribe to my channel. Check out my Instagram, TheN2. I always post some stuff there between videos. Feel free to make suggestions for my next plan on any of my social media. I'm sure you guys got some good ideas and little nutheads of yours. It's been a pleasure trying to slaughter your kind, and see you next time. And after that, hopefully,
never again.